and having a focus on accomplishing whatever task is assigned to you, you also become great leaders, and some of you who have the willingness become entrepreneurs. So different type of activities will be there for each one of you to ensure that your entrepreneurial skills are also enhanced during your 2 years program within the institute. Friends, the young boys and aspirants, boys and girls, the aspirants who want to become MBA, who will be taking this 2 years program, it is a very challenging time for all of us. But I am confident the way our country is progressing that you will be in good times. India today is on the forefront of being one of the fastest growing countries in the world. We all know that the country is growing at a GDP of over 7%, and with the various programs and initiatives taken by the government, it is likely that in the next 2 or 3 years, we will be growing at more than 8 to 9%. So it is a very interesting time for people who are pursuing management courses in today's situation. Our Prime Minister has a vision, and he's also on the forefront at the global scenario. He is rated as the top 3 leaders in the world, and it is on every and each and every topic he ensures that he is center stage, whether it is global warming or any other program which is of global concern to everybody. He is respected, and India's voice in the global scenario is being counted upon by each and every country in this world. Because of all of you, today we are the youngest population in the country, the median age being 32, and it is for you all to perform so that the country grows the way we think and the world thinks that the India will be growing in future. It is believed by most of the people that India will become a $11 trillion economy by the year 2030, and that is something which we should be proud of. But this can be achieved if the young demography that we have the right skill sets, and they are able to do the jobs which are required by the industry in the future. As you all know that the GST, the Goods and Service Tax, has been implemented from 1st of July, and that will make more and more investments both in industry and service sector within our country. And we are looking for huge foreign direct investment coming into our country because of this. The initiatives taken by the Prime Minister, whether it is Startup India, Digital India, or Make in India, is very promising. And we feel that India will become a manufacturing hub, a hub for innovation and growth, which will be looked by the world with great satisfaction. I was reading the Economic Times today, and I was reading a report wherein it said that India has become the third largest user of digital technologies and social media. The Economic Times gave some data, and it said the internet users today in India are 465 million people who are using internet. On Facebook, there are more than 200 million people, and similarly on YouTube. LinkedIn, 42 million people from India alone. Instagram, 35 million people. And I would encourage each one of you who is not on social media or who are not using these facilities to be a part of it, because that will make you interconnected, that will make you learn new things, new ideas, new concepts. And I will encourage the faculty to ensure that each and every student who is here should be exposed to these type of modern techniques and technologies, which will help them in their personal development and continue to be connected with the world. The internet rate has become the cheapest in our country. It is not China or America or Europe where the rates are lower, but it is India. And the government is encouraging every one of us to use it, the bandwidth is being increased, and everybody right at the bottom of the pyramid is being encouraged to take advantage of the benefit of technology that is all pervasive. Well, friends, we have seen that how technology is shaping the way we live today. So many new things are happening in this ever-changing world that it is very difficult for each one of us, whether we are in industry or education, to keep pace with it. I am with a background with industry, having managed a lot of companies in textiles, even newspapers, construction, etc. But we are changing how things are rapidly changing. And we also have to re-engineer and reinvent ourselves. This applies to management institute like ours, where we continuously change our pedagogy, the way we teach, and we expect the people who are here, all our dear students, to also understand that it is a very dynamic situation today. You have to be constant learners. You have to understand that whatever is being taught in the school is something which is important and you have to pay attention to. But despite that, all other activities that they are going in the college, whether it is role play, whether it is simulations, games, and whether various experts will be meeting you from the industry or from the academics will be coming and interacting with you, and also engaging with the alumni. Each one of them will be important and relevant for you, so that you can stay ahead of the curve and learn more and more during your 2 years of stay here in the campus.